the more we can sensitize the entire student body to the needs of the Francophone community, the more you will be able to respond to the school's mandate and giving appropriate medical services to various groups in Northern Ontario. So I look forward to having discussions with you locally and by video conference.
My journey with NOSM started almost at the very beginning, and I was part of the school's Francophone Advisory Committee. The school had, right from the onset, put together a committee to be able to receive feedback and advice from the Francophone community as to how they would be able to integrate elements that were critical to better serve Francophone population when it came to healthcare. Was its chair and was involved with a great team of individuals to put together the first Francophone symposium in 2012. I became a medical student in the undergraduate medical program. And for me, the unique aspects of the Northern Ontario School of Medicine, it's the social accountability mandate. We've highlighted certain scenarios, absolutely, in the case of the modules that first-year learners undertake, where the case-based studies are highlighting certain specific unique aspects of dealing with Francophone populations. So in that context, the curriculum integrates opportunities to review those types of scenarios. On another level, ICE placements occur in second year, and the students will have two blocks. So in those circumstances, many of the communities that are selected to be ICE placement blocks for the students also have Francophone populations. So I think what's interesting in that context is that when they go into those communities, preceptors are very familiar with their patient populations and look forward to having Francophone students in their community to be able to assist with the engagement with the population. Secondly, in being able to develop communication skills that are particular in engaging with Francophone patients. And in other communities, the preceptors themselves can be Francophone as well. So Francophone preceptors will be able to assist learners in developing their terminology, developing their approach, developing their interaction with other clinicians in French. So that's another aspect. I think from outside of the formal curriculum, there's a very large number of activities that are being developed with teams of physicians, as well as the Francophone Affairs Office, whereby students get to engage in what the curriculum specific sessions are called SES sessions. So they're the clinical skills development sessions. Being Francophone or speaking French puts you in a situation where you're able to at least engage with respect to communications with Francophone populations. But I think for certain learners, I think what's important to realize is that even though they may be learning their curriculum in English, they have a multitude of opportunities to be able to engage in exchanging with patients and clinical staff in French as well. So one of the things that I find important is you need to realize that regardless of the fact that you may be learning a lot of your material in English, you will always have the opportunity and you must seek out opportunities to do them in French as well. That helps develop your confidence in using the terminology in French. It also, from the clinical perspective, develops your ability to deliver reports to your clinicians and preceptors in French. But most of all, I think one needs to realize that you don't have to have a very complex clinical terminology or vocabulary to be able to engage the patient. I think sometimes we're often confronted with patients that have a very hard time communicating in English. And if someone can actually sit down and express themselves in their own language, it makes that dialogue easier between the patient and the clinician. The patient is reassured. It's very stressful to be sick. It's even more stressful when you're put in a situation where you don't find your language skills are appropriate enough to be able to give a good description to the doctor or other healthcare providers. So this sort of creates an environment where the patient has at least some comfort in speaking their own language. If you recognize someone would be more forthcoming or more comfortable in French, This is also important to highlight to other providers in the team. So maybe you won't have a team where all the healthcare providers speak French, but those who do can be of assistance. I'll cite, for example, in the clinical situations where you have often specialists that don't speak French, but as a learner who can engage patients in their own language, you can be that person who helps the specialist have that dialogue with the patient, again, providing some level of comfort and reassurance. For a very long time, Francophone populations were more susceptible to be at higher risk of certain diseases because of certain lifestyle choices as well. So often a higher rate of smoking in Francophone populations. Often a lot of musculoskeletal injuries based on the industries Francophone individuals have been working in over the past many years. If I look at it from a perspective of more elderly Francophone populations, very different in the sense that if you did manage to go to school, many of the individuals did not go to school past eighth grade or maybe early high school. So the level of literacy for more elderly individuals can be at a different level. Oftentimes, and I think I'm not particularly certain that this would be limited to Francophone populations, but it's certainly something that I see quite often is that patients will not be forthcoming in identifying areas where they haven't understood instructions if they had been delivered in English. They'll just, nod and smile. Yes, okay, yes. Other elements of concern for Francophone populations, especially in smaller communities that have a very elevated percentage of Francophone individuals, is that oftentimes they need to be treated at a tertiary center, but they don't necessarily access services that are appropriate for them. And this is usually a very difficult situation for patients. One, they come from a very small community. Two, they may not have never left their home community. Three, they sometimes have to travel there by themselves because the distances that they need to travel are too far, and family has to meet them by ground transportation, and they're flown there. So they're greeted with a team of unilingual Anglophone individual in a large city, large hospital. They're all confused. They're not going to start arguing with doctors or trying to do the, please, I need health services in French, I don't understand. They'll just do the nod and smile, right? So I think what's important for students to realize is that as future physicians and in our role in learning to become future physicians, we also need to be able to identify when someone is struggling based on challenges with communications or differences in language, etc. So our job is to make sure, check in with the patient that they really understood. And we can also be of service by understanding that when someone has a language difference or cultural differences, whether it be Francophone or any other culture, we have an opportunity to highlight that to other providers that may be down the line to serve these patients. So as a good example, for me, it's a part and parcel of what I do when I come to Hearst as a locum physician to ensure that if a patient is being transferred to a tertiary center, that I'm going to highlight that on the documentation, that they're unilingual Francophone. It is important to find someone that may be able to assist the patient once they arrive because they don't speak English. And this is something that's very common in certain communities in Northern Ontario. Having the opportunity even on the floor in larger tertiary centers, when I have patients that are Francophone, you have the, oh my goodness, you speak French, that's so great, and they feel relieved trying to organize their care on the floor. Not making people feel like they're not able to provide care for patients on the floor if they don't speak French, but making sure that if there's an opportunity, hey, would it be possible to have this patient matched up with a French-speaking nurse? This would be a lot easier for the patient, and I think as far as the quality of the care we can provide would be, enhanced or improved. So those are a few examples where it's important to be able to start developing that sixth sense about whether or not the patient is understanding where you're coming from, that they understand instructions that you provided for them, because they impact the quality of the care that you give down the line.